Hello everyone. Hello, welcome to the stream. It's Friday. We have one more stream about AmigaOS. I'm George. You can find me as Volquero in various different Amiga forums. Welcome to the stream, Javier, and welcome Creevy. Welcome. I'm glad I'm having you here today. Where we are going to visit AmigaOS 4 for this stream, and we are going to have a look on various programs that have to do with design and graphics. And it's a good opportunity for me to show you my artistic abilities, which I have none, and so, and you will see that in a few minutes. But I would like to show you a few things from applications that you can design something there, and also 3D applications. And let's start. Javier says, pity I'm out drinking some beers. Yeah, that's a pity, yeah, right. we'll try to join us up or watch it offline. Yeah, Javier, I feel so sorry about you. great streams you are doing, Volker. Thank you very much. Thank you. I'm glad you like it. And yeah, basically because people like them and watch them, and that's the reason why I'm doing all these streams, right? And but I want this to be a live stream because I want this interaction with you guys. So please share the videos. I upload all the videos after a few days on YouTube as well. Please share the videos and with your friends, your Amiga friends basically, and so that more people can know about it and have more people here on the stream, on the live stream, and have a party. Hello Aris Amiga, welcome to the stream. So today we are going to have a look on a few programs that have to do with designing. And we have seen that a couple of streams ago, but I want to give you a better overlook on them. We have seen that there are a lot of applications that run from 68K AmigaOS, and because those applications are written for this CPU, 68K from Motorola. And they are running quite well on AmigaOS 4 with the emulation layer that AmigaOS 4 has, which is called Petunia. What you need to do is just double click on an application and it runs just fine. For example, here Artifact, it runs quite well. So let me set here no, this is too big. 768. And later I'm going to show you one more a hardware piece that you can use with these applications, that it might be useful for the people that want to design something, to draw something on their computer, on their Amiga ones. So here we have the Artifact. It is running quite well. You have all the filters available to do something, right? Let me open an image. Let's see this one. Out of memory, yeah. I think we had that issue before. Let's keep that. Okay, let me start again. White, okay. Why? Okay. It seems that it doesn't want. Ah, yeah. I had a configuration here that might break the design. No. To be honest, before the stream, I was a little bit prepared and I tested that application again. So let me try. Okay. What am I missing? Ah, okay. You see, it's configuration. So the artifact is working just fine. You can design anything or work with images and apply some effects there, or cut and or crop images, or things like that, and then you can save them in different formats. Welcome SLD Snake, welcome to the stream. So, but before we start using any of the applications that I have in mind today, I would like to show you a tool that I'm using whenever I'm trying to design something. This is an XP-Pen, that's the brand, and this is a tablet where you can go and design something with a pen, like that. This is quite compatible with the AmigaOS 4, and you can find it on various stores out there. It's available. I checked a few minutes ago on the Amazon, on the German Amazon, and this is available around 65 euros. That's the cost of this tablet. You can use it because it is much more easier to draw something using a tablet than using the mouse. And before you can use it on the AmigaOS 4, it comes of course with a cable that's a USB cable. And let me show you the box. That's the box of the tablet. So you, if you are interested and would you like to buy it, this is available. Of course, I'm not at any way affiliated with this product. I just find it very compatible with AmigaOS 4. That's why I propose you that. And before you buy it, before you use it, you have to download the drivers. If you go to let me show you. If you go to OS4 Depot and search for tablet, okay, there are these drivers, UG tablet. They were created by Andy Broad. Andy Broad is also the developer of one of the applications that we will see in a few minutes, the SketchBlock Pro. Okay. And you can download these drivers. Let me download them and save them in RAM. Okay. So if you download them and extract them, the only thing that you need to do is to copy this file into the devices USB FD in here. As you can see, I have that already there. And UG tablet FD class file into these FD classes. That's the only thing that you will need to do. And also with the driver, there is available the source code, so people who would like to write something similar, they have something to start from. So let's see what you can do with that. First of all, you have to take the cable, of course, and connect it. Since you have the drivers installed, you have to connect it to the tablet. The good thing with this tablet is that the pen that you are using doesn't have any batteries in there, so it is quite light and you can use it quite easily. So then you plug it at an USB port and it is ready to be used. Let me move this keyboard and have that in front of me, top camera, like that. Okay, so with the tablet you can design something here, or you can use it as a mouse. So as you can see, I'm moving the mouse with the tablet and it feels more natural. So as I said before, the developer of this tablet drivers has also developed the SketchBlock Pro. SketchBlock Pro is only available for AmigaOS 4. It is a program where you can design something and do something like that. As you can see, my artistic abilities are very good. The other feature that this tablet has, and the drivers especially, is that you can even tilt a little bit the pen, and this can be reflect to your to the way that you design on the screen. For example, let me go here. If I select size and opacity, you will see that I can design, and if I press it more, it gets more dark, and the weight of the design of the color is more bold. You can select another color and you can do whatever you want here. For example, that's the best thing that I can do. So with this pen, you can design if you have an ability to draw something more naturally, and the application SketchBlock, because it is native and it's a new application, has supports this pen quite well. But the drivers of this pen are supporting other older applications as well. So let me show you here. No. Whenever you plug the tablet at the USB of your system, if you check the exchange, there is a commodity running, which if you check, it has information about these about the drivers of this tablet. Here you can see exactly the points where the cursor is right now. If I go up to the top left corner, it goes to zero. Right? If I go down to the bottom right corner, it has the maximum values. So this is something that you can use. For example, if you want to have this area only to draw and not all the tablet, you can do it by setting the values of this point, for example, the bottom right corner, which you want to for that to be. If you want to be here, then you have to go to this commodity, and you can see that if I move to that point, I have some current X and current Y numbers, and those values I can set them here, and that's the maximum area that I want to use on my tablet, and that covers all the other screen. Thanks, SLD Snake. Thank you very much. So that's a way to set an area on your tablet. Also, you can set it not always to start from the top right corner if you want. If you want to set it to start from here until here, you can do it by finding from this tool the coordinates and use them here in these fields. That's very useful. And with this driver, there is, let me see, there is a documentation, a README text file, where has there are all the information on how to install it and how to use that tool. You can find all the information there. Andy has done so much very nice work with that. So yeah, you can use it as a mouse in your workbench quite well. And let's see what else you can do with SketchBlock. Not only you can load images and crop them or something like that, but you can also create icons for the AmigaOS 4. Hello Falcon, welcome to the stream. For example, I use that a lot because I like for games that I do not have any icon. For example, emulator games from Commodore 64, like that. I like to make icons from the graphics. Let me see what we could experiment a little bit. I have here T0, okay, and I have this image screenshot and this title right here. So I will say, let's take this icon and make an icon for the AmigaOS 4. So I will take, of course, I'm not an expert with all these applications. I'm just showing you how I use them. Okay. So what I did right now to open this file, I ran the SketchBlock in a separated screen, right? And I dragged the screen in at the side and then dragged the image into the file requester, which is something that's quite useful for me at least. And it speeds up a lot of things. So right now we have that here, that's the image. And I would like first to crop it, right? So to do it, you have to go to resize image. You keep the lock aspect, maybe. I'm not sure, I will remove it. And then you can go and say crop contents, scale contents. No, crop contents. And what you can, maybe let's go to select the area that we want to use. Okay, let me remove the aspect like that. That's the area that I would like to crop. Okay. And then if we open resize image, we can do 29, 108, no, 29, 108, okay, no, that was wrong, so let me undo that. there is a way. Let me do here the same size. Okay. Layers. Yeah. Scale or resize the layer, because you might not see that here at the right side. This application supports layers, like you can find on GIMP in Linux computer operating system, or the Photoshop for other computers, right? For Windows or Mac. So what I want to do is go to the layer, scale or resize layer. I will disable scale and keep crop, remove the lock aspect and move here the area. That's much better, like that. And resize layer. So as you can see here, right now I have the layer just fine. So in let me see the chat. Sketch is native AmigaOS 4 program. I came too late. The SketchBlock, yes, it's an AmigaOS 4 application only. Yeah, as Perseta says, better late than never. Hello, Perseta, welcome to the stream. I am stockpiling some new hardware for Amiga 1200, accelerator, RTC, module scan, doubler, etc. I have no time to install it. I hope in Christmas time I will find some. Yeah, I hope so, Perseta. That's a good, a few good hardware there. Nice, very nice. What kind of accelerator you refer to? So for the AmigaOS 4, you have a limit of 255 pixels for the icons. Okay, so right now what we need to do is, since we crop that, we need to resize the image to maximum 255. Let's go with 200 pixels. Okay, and since I have the lock aspect, it keeps changing the new height. Scale. Okay, and if we zoom a little bit so that we can see that, like that, we have the small icon image. Okay, and an image, an icon has two states, right? So before we do anything here, it is it has two states, the icon. When you press it, it changes to something else. Hello, Liveout, welcome to the stream. Late again, courtesy of Twitch notification being set late. Yeah, I was thinking about that. Maybe I should start the stream 10 minutes before the actual time, right? But if tell me, guys, is there any way where you would like me to announce the stream somewhere, maybe on Twitter or somewhere else? Perseta says yes, actually I have Terrible Fire installed, but just no time to tweak and play with it. Okay, Terrible Fire is pretty good. It's 1260, right? Little says, oh, my fav SketchBlock Pro. Yeah, very nice application, right? 11 Dylan Dog games to Lemon Amiga yesterday. 11 games, wow. In my opinion, people should go and add their games their own, especially for the new ones, and you shouldn't have to add them manually, right? Playing all them was really exhausting and frustrating. Okay, yeah. Livelo says, I don't have anything social networking, maybe on IMP. Maybe, yeah, okay, I will do that. So, what you have to do here, right now the image has this layer in here, but I would like to make this layer to make it an icon, so we need two stages, the one that is the icon unchecked, unselected, and the one that is selected. So if I double here, there is, let me show you, of course this what we see here today is not a tutorial for a sketch block, right? Just an idea to show you a couple of things. If I'm not wrong, this is the yeah, it copies this layer to a second one. Let's say that this one is the one that will have the glow effect, and the next one is the basic one. So we have here this image, and this will get the glow effect. If I go here on miscellaneous and apply glow, you will see that nothing happens. That's because the image, the layer, doesn't have space to draw the glow icon. So I will undo that, and we need the layer, which is this area here, to get bigger. Resize layer. But we don't want to scale it. Expand layer to, let me see here. Let me remove the lock aspect and here. Okay. Course you can fine tune that like that and remove some pixels like that, 204 to 162. I think that's fine. Resize layer. Okay, and now can we apply the glow? Let me see. Apply glow? No. The reason that we can't apply the glow right now is because the background got some white color. Let me do that again. So I will have that to like that, transparent, 0, 0. Resize layer. Oh my god. Yeah, why? Did I miss something here? Expand. Remove this one. 0 and 0. I'm thinking that okay. what I'm going to do is SLD Snake says, I receive mostly all of the tweets notifications, but another option is welcome to Twitter. I don't know. Yeah, I will try to do that. I spend most of the Amiga NG with SketchBlock. I hope Origin will add more to it. Actually, the SketchBlock is developed by Andy Broad. But so far it is really good comparing to nothing. It is very good. Unfortunately, it has a little bit, it needs some time to spend to understand how it works, right? Falcon 11 says you will use invert an image to second status of icon. If I would like to do the invert Falcon, I shouldn't do anything on here because AmigaOS has that automatically. If I would like to do that, you can change that, you can set that on the preferences if the image has a single state only. But what I want to do is to have two stages with a glow around the icon. That what I'm showing here is a good way to design your own icons. If someone wants to create his own icons, that's a good way to do it. Liberal says, God bless Imp. By the way, have you noticed you when just have a newborn son? Yeah, I read about that. That's very good. I think he will have no time for updates for some time. What can you do? The application is quite well done. Even right now, so let's give him a break and he's going to be back, right? Glow to icon you will use. Yeah, glow to icon, Falcon, you're right. The thing is that I did that a couple of days ago. Let me remember, because it's the thing that this application has a little bit of weird way to do things. For example, you have to go inside the scale, resize a layer to scale it. Okay. And for those that came late today, I would like to mention again that I'm using a pen tablet here. Okay, so that's a good way to do design and draw something on your Amiga. And it works quite well. Okay. Let me think why this is happening. Resize image. Scale and resize. No, it does that all the time. No, really. really happy for him. Yes, that will be trying times for him, but glad current state of IMP is solid. Yeah, it is quite solid IMP right now, and even on AmigaOS 4, I think he probably fixed the issue that we were having with AmigaOS 4 and IMP. When you close the IMP, it was crashing something. Liberal, you have the same tablet? Good, good. Presetta says, I also have a Wacom tablet attached to my Amiga 1200. Yes? Using serial or USB, Presetta? Liberal says, my latest purchase was Wacom Pen Partner for Classic Amiga. Nice. Is it working well with some specific drivers? Do you remember the drivers? Mixel Labs YouTube webpage helped me to find out which one to get. Yeah, exactly. Thanks, Livelord, for saying that. Mixel Labs on his YouTube channel has a very good video about tablets and the Amiga. And also, Kevin Saunders has some videos about that, if I'm not wrong, right? Presetta says, I am a big Mixel fan, patroning him from the beginning. Yeah, he's doing very good work, right? It works in Artifact. Mixel have all the links needed for drivers. Yes. Yeah, I will put a link of his video on the description of my stream video when I upload that on YouTube. So if anyone of you misses that, he will find it there. So yes, I tried to remember what I did before. Maybe it's because of the image, the way that I loaded the image. Let me try that from scratch. So let me have a new image, transparent, okay. Or let me open that again. And select here, copy selection, okay. And create a new image, which is transparent, and try to paste it here and see how it goes. Yes. Okay, not what I wanted, but what I'm going to do is layer, scale and resize here. Okay, like that. Here, resize layer. Okay. And if I'm not wrong, fit image to layers. Okay, let me remove that. Let me show you full screen. Okay. And from here, layers, image, fit image to layers. Great. So we have right now this image. Okay, let me resize that to lock aspect, scale contents, like it is, to 200, okay, like that. And let me zoom. That's great. And now what I need to do is to make that space around the image. So what I need to do is to resize the image again to, let's say, 240, but locking the aspect without scaling and keep the contents on the center. So if I go to 240 like that, scale. Okay, and now I'm going to resize the layer to be on the same size like the image. The image is 200 and 125, we can see that on the title. So scale, resize the layer, scale layer, okay, 240, no, cancel, again, not scale, expand layer, let's keep it that, 240, 125. Okay, this one should be 0 and 0 to go at the top right corner. Resize layer. Great. I think we are doing well. Let me see the chat. Kevin Saunders will be in Amiga Build stream tomorrow. Oh, nice. Didn't know that. Presenting. Oh, yeah, the reshooter. The Proxima, right? Yeah. The third. I look forward for this game. Sunday, yes. Livelord says that Mixel is talented and a good chap, left a good impression on me. I approve totally. Yep, he's a very good guy. And I look forward for his game as well. He is doing a very nice job. By the way, Patron Kevin too. Very good. Well done, guys, for supporting all these people, because they are creating so much stuff for the AmigaOS. And also, they train the rest of us, like me, who am not having any artistic abilities, as I said before, train how to do things, and that's very, very interesting and very good. Falcon 11 says, you forgot copy image, or actually, copy image, you mean to copy the... I did the copy of the image from the previous one. Now what I'm going to do is to create a second layer, and here, as you can see, and let me rename that as glow, and let's hope that it's going to work. Actually, I believe that it's going to work right now, because I don't know if you can see, let me see, yeah, you can see here a slight blue line here around the image, at the edge of the image. That's the borders of the layer that I have right now enabled. Okay, so we have space here, and here is the image. So if I go to the menu at the top and select apply glow, it applies the glow. Yeah! So we have here two images, one without the glow and one with the glow. Awesome, awesome. It is awesome. And the last thing that remains to be done is export as Amiga icon info, add RAM icon.info. That's the name of the file. Export. And since it didn't complain, I believe that this is done. Here it is. So right now, when I select it, it glows. And when I don't select it, it's playing like that. And here that I have the script that is for the game, I can drag and drop it in there, save it, and I have a brand new icon for the game after 5 hours. So I can do something like that, hide all the other files, and here, snapshot, no, cleanup, okay, select contents, okay, snapshot all, we are, no, here, resize to fit, great, snapshot all, great, we are done, and double click on that, and we have the game. That's how you can use the SketchBlock Pro. SketchBlock Pro is a commercial application. You can find it on the Ami store. Let me show you here. So we can see exactly where you can find it and how much it costs. And of course, it's not only for creating icons, but if you remember on previous, here it is, first of all. If you remember from previous streams, we said that the AmigaOS 4 has a utility that's icon edit, but it is pretty old. You can't do actually anything with that. It needs an update. So if someone wants to create icons like I did for the games or anything else, he can do it with SketchBlock, and it's a very good application. But of course, it has so many other options and things that you can do. Andy, who created that application, he uses that for drawing and yeah, it's very nice application to do that. Undo, and especially with a pen tablet, it's very, very good to create something here. But let's see how we can use this, the tablet, the pen tablet, to with other applications. As I said before, the driver that that supports this specific tablet, pen tablet, is able to work with other applications, with old applications as well. And also, it has, let me show you here, UG tablet, or it's, as I said, a commodity that runs whenever you plug the tablet on your AmigaOS. If there is an application that doesn't support the tablet, there is a selection here, use tablet, and it uses an old way of the tablets to communicate with the applications. I haven't tested that, to be honest, but I will show you the application that I tested it, and they work just fine. Preseta says, you also train us, much appreciated. Thank you, Preseta. You missed a couple of streams ago because we have seen so many things about AmigaOS 4, but while we were doing that, especially on the previous one, we see also a lot of applications that run inside AmigaOS 4, but they are also available for AmigaOS 3. So through these streams, I have the chance to show also applications that can be used on the classic Amigas, right? Which is awesome. Although I'm not an expert on any of them, you saw just right now that I wanted to create an icon and it took me ages. Although that I have done that a lot of times, yeah, but it takes some time. So what application? Let's see Artifact. And create a new image here. /768 and select white, okay, and select this brush. As you can see here right now, I can design, but I don't have, it doesn't change anything even if I select here with pressure to change the opacity, you see that it changes. So if I design without pressing a lot, it's more transparent, but if I press, it changes. But I think that if you go to here on settings and select Tableau, it's more, it works much better with this pen tablet. And you can design with that and also change the color based on how much you press. Unfortunately, this application doesn't support the tilt of the pen. So if you draw something that you don't have the pen straight to the tablet, but you turn it a little bit, if you design something, it doesn't change. The SketchBlock does that. It supports the tilt. So you see that the pen, the graphics that the pen creates is different. Falcon 11 says T0 is go through emulation. Petunia, T0 doesn't work with Petunia because Petunia doesn't have support for the custom chipset. Petunia is able to run 68K code, but it doesn't have any support for custom chipsets. So it runs applications that use RTG graphics, like the Artifact. For me, to play the T0 and other games are done using the EUI, and there is a running UI that supports that. It's, let's say, a front end for EUI to play the game. So if I come here and double click, first of all, T0 is a script, okay, that gets into this folder and run a configuration with UI. So if I double click on that, it starts the game. And I have a lot of games set up like that. And it is easy because if you have running UI, if you click double click on any 68K game, it will start with that. Even if you have an ADF file, I have done a stream a few days ago about all the games and how you can run them in AmigaOS 4. Little says, I'm going to watch from the beginning. I think I have some issues with select box. If this is the case, will bug Andy on amigans.net. Yeah, if you have any problems with the application, talk to Andy. He is quite responsive and helps a lot. And as you can see, yeah, it works fine with the Artifact. I have to check what's the situation with the memory of the Artifact. It should work just fine. Another application that I know that it works quite well with the pen is Photogenics. I think I ran it 2 times. Let me quit it. Okay. Okay, let me reboot. Probably you remember that we ran before Photogenics. It works quite well. I don't know why it crashed. Possibly I ran it 2 times, so we will see it in a few seconds. Yeah, and other than Photogenics, we are going to see a few other stuff. I'm going to run a Lightwave, and possibly we will see Blender as well. Okay. I'm not used at the pen tablet at all because it's something that you have to use it a lot. I knew a person a few years ago that was using all the time pen tablets with any operating system that he was using, and he was not able to work without a pen tablet. Sometimes he didn't have the pen tablet with him, so he was unable to work with it. It's something that you have to get used to it, right? So I don't know about you guys. Do you use pen tablets at all on daily or at work or something? Okay, let me unlock it. Great. And let's get back to designing. Photogenics. Like that. Okay. Now it works just fine. Right? So, let me find. Yeah. That. White background. As much as I searched on this application, I tried to find if there are configurations about the pressure sensitivity in tablets. I didn't find anything, but it seems that it doesn't support much. It depends actually on the item that you use. For example, here you see that this is less bold, but unfortunately I didn't find any specific information about how Photogenics is working with the tablets. Maybe it's my perception that is working, but you can use it quite well. For example, here I did that line by pressing a lot, and now I did it by not pressing a lot on the pen, and you see that there are a couple of differences on the way that these lines were designed. Liberal says using drawing tablet only for drawing, it's awkward to use it as a mouse. Yeah, it is. Also, it is awkward to draw something with the mouse, right? I had a tiny tablet at the Windows Vista era. I didn't use it so much. I have a Wacom so many years ago, SLD Snake, like you said. It's almost the half of this tablet that I'm having right now, but it has an issue, and I'm trying to find a way to find a new pen or try to fix it, but it was working quite well with the AmigaOS 4. And yeah, it depends what you are doing, but to be honest, right now that I have that tablet, which is much bigger, it feels more natural. You have a liberal, you have issues with the audio. Does anyone else have issues with the audio? Okay. It is breaking. What it is it doing? With the audio, uh, Okay, now you can hear me quite well. Please tell me. I hope you can hear me quite well right now. So, let's see here. You hear me okay, but with issues. Okay, let me. I don't see any problem here, but you never know. It might be the microphone. Okay, let's continue. We will see what we can do. That's all from Photogenics. Okay. What else? There is an application called Graphics version 2.5. This is Livelo says you don't think still issues. You don't think it's the microphone. Okay, let me see what I can do. Give me a sec, guys. Is there a possibility that it is too low or not? How you can hear me right now? Is it better? I cut the sound totally from the computer, so it might help. Now it is okay. Thanks, Falcon. Thank you very much. We're talking about the Graphics 2. This is an application that exists on different computers, operating systems, sorry. And this is an application that is based on SDL, so it is easy in a way to port it. Great, thank you very much. Thank you, guys. To port it to different operating systems. So that's why it is also available for AmigaOS. It's an open source application, and it is for those who like to do pixel graphics. And that's the reason why these kind of applications do not, at least I didn't find any way to support the tablet. Because I believe that it's something that people who are doing pixel graphics are not do not care about the pressure sensitivity and things like that, but it can be used quite well with this application and helps a lot to draw something here. But actually what it does is it uses the pen tablet as a mouse. If I was using the mouse, you are doing the same thing. But of course with the pen tablet you can design much better things. Okay, even me. Falcon level, of course, man. Thank you for not ignoring me. So yeah, graphics is very nice if you are doing graphics, pixel graphics, especially if you want to create something on your Amiga with a nice tool. It's very, very good, and also it has some extra features, like you can have layers here. Let me add here a layer where I can set up something like that. Here you are, a big brown circle, just to show you that if you go above the layers here, you can see the designs of the layers, and you can rearrange them and move the layer above it, or even move the layer, the actual layer, and place it somewhere else. That's very nice to have. And the other good thing with this application is that it supports a lot of formats. Even from Commodore 64, you can load images, or where is it? You can load GIF images, PNG images, and do whatever you want. And I don't know if you have seen that when I run it. Here, at the first requester, it has two buttons. One that says anim, and it is useful to create your animations, and you can save your animations as a GIF animations and use them wherever you want. That's pretty good, looks Spartan, but I can see the appeal. Yeah, it's a very, very good application because it is something like what we have with Deluxe Paint. Okay, it's close to that. And it has some effects that you can do, you can use. But yeah, as I said, it doesn't support the pen tablets, okay, but it is, if you have a pen tablet, it works quite well with that, and it's quite helpful to use a pen tablet while you draw something. Okay, let's see, let's go to Lightwave. For those of you that like to do 3D stuff with Lightwave, here I loaded the modeler where you can, which you can use to create your models. Okay. Today I was watching a YouTube video from Holden Modify. He's doing a very good job, and he's having a lot of videos where he's explaining the basic things about the Lightwave. There is also the videos, the channel on YouTube from Muad'Dib 3D. Which you can find a lot of very good tutorials about Lightwave if you would like to do it. So let me show you here how you can use the pen tablet with this application and why this might be useful. So I have, as you can see, I think you can see it. Let me. The good thing with the modeler is that you can, what I did, okay, is that you can use the RTG graphics card, the Picasso drivers right now, and you can scale it to whatever you want. Right now I'm using the modeler on 1080p resolution, right? Yeah, it is a native screen. It is a 1080p resolution, 1920 to 1080 with 32-bit. The reason that I'm doing that in 32-bit is when I want to return to workbench, you see that it is also available at the back, and I don't wait for the monitor to change the resolutions. If you change it to different color depth, you have some waiting time from the monitor. That's why I always do a 32-bit. And let's, yeah, and I was watching today the video from Holden Modify, where he was creating something like a box and something like that, and you can create the box as he showed, or go and create a ball. Like that. Of course, he was doing that in a better way, right? And yeah, the thing is that when you do something like that on Lightwave to see the objects, or if you want to go and select something. Let me see here at the bottom. I want to select these points, these polygons. Okay, it's much easier to do it, in my opinion, with a pen tablet than with a mouse. Of course, it is a thing that has to do with the experimentation, right? On AmigaOS 3 is needed a mode pro for that, because Amiga resolution is supported. Have I right or am I wrong? Actually, for the modeler, you don't need a mode pro, because modeler is able from these display and options. You can select any screen that you have available. So modeler supports any RTG if you have it. We are going to go to the layout of because Lightwave is two programs, actually. The modeler, where you go and create your models, your artists, okay, the objects that you are going to have into your scene, and the layout, where you go and get all your artists and place them into the scene, and the camera and the lighting, okay. The layout is the one that you need to use a mode pro to promote the screen, because it doesn't support other RTG resolutions. The modeler does support it, and it works quite well. So yeah, and also if you need to select something, let's see, with the right mouse button, like that. Okay, I did it a little bit more complicated than it was needed. Let me select that, like that. It's much more easier to do it with the pen tablet. And of course, yeah, this way here to see the item, it's much more natural to rotate your objects. And that's good that we have the drivers that support those kind of tablets. So right here, right now, it sounded like the song. Right now I have the layout loaded, as you can see. This is mode promoted. This can be done from preferences and screens. You will see here I have Lightwave promoted from this resolution that Lightwave layout uses to this resolution here. It's 1080p, it works quite well. And you can come here and load the scene. For example, this one. Okay. Let me set this. Assign. Okay. So if I want to have the camera, to move the camera, again, for me, in my opinion, it is more natural to place the items where you want to do it and move the items around your layout using a pen tablet. As you can see, it works just fine on AmigaOS 4, and you can select something like that. No. And do whatever you want with the camera or the lights or the items. Move. And yeah, and that's the way that it works on AmigaOS 4. How long take rendering on X5000? Which scene and in what resolution? There are a lot of parameters that we have to take care of. If we want to compare a couple of two hardwares, we have to have the same scene for the same resolution. Everything should be the same. Now, in Lightwave, when you try to, when you press F9, if I'm not wrong, then a new screen opens, actually two screens, where you see the rendering, right? And a preview of the rendering. That doesn't work well with the AmigaOS 4 because the resolutions of these screens are quite weird and they are not able to be promoted, mode promoted. So what I am doing when I want to render something, whenever I want to do something like that, I'm using, in Lightwave, there is a binary, the LWSN FP, because FP is because it uses floating point. And I'm using that. Here you can see it. It has, you give it a specific scene, and then you can give it the frames, how many frames from that frame to that frame if you want, and it creates the images, it does the rendering. And that can be done here on the using from the terminal. That's what I'm doing. And it starts and renders all the images of the scene. And when it is finished, it is finished. And it works quite well. Yes, that's X5040. It's struggling with the movement of the track image, says Livelord. Okay. Let me open that again. Camera, let me move it. The reason that it might seem that it struggles is, first of all, it is 1080p resolution, right? And also, if I remember correct, here we have there is a threshold for the bounding box. Okay, that's the number that counts the points of the item, and after a number of points, when you do this movement, it turns it to a box instead of having that like that full displayed. So it is 10,000 here, and so you don't see that as a box. If I reduce that to 1000, less, let me do that less. Ah, yeah, I didn't press enter. You see that right now it turns it to a box because the number of points are much more than the threshold. That's a good way to speed up the movement. The benchmark texture scene is a good test. Yeah, I can do that and show you how much it takes to render it. Falcon Level says, yes, of course, I understand which resolution, etc., but affect this. Sorry, Falcon, I didn't understand the last part of after, but for example, this has you have now. So, sorry. SLD Snake says, I needed to reduce the colors to 8 in mode pro to make it move smoothly, if I remember correctly, but I didn't know that points option. Yeah, that points is crucial for the movement. Because if your scene has too many points, it is more difficult to move all of them, right? Yes, that makes sense. I would guess no one would render 1080p movie just single image. Yeah, maybe, maybe not. I think that the people that would like to create a movie from a Lightwave, it is better to use something like a render farm, many computers, and the best way, in my opinion, to do it without having issues, having computers all day long running and I don't know, have issues with the power, is to use Raspberry Pis. If you check the channel from Muad'Dib on YouTube, there is a video there where he refers on that. On having many Raspberry Pis running the emulator for AmigaOS 3, and you have there the ScreamNet, and you give a scene to all these computers and they start rendering the frames. But if you want to do it on your computer, you can do it. I would prefer not to have the X5000 running all the time, having this monster running all the time, all day, just to render, I don't know, a lot of frames, right? Yeah, that will be good to do if you want this benchmark. I guess you refer to ray trace. This one, right? Yeah, I will let me check about it. SLD Snake says, oh, I heard about that parallel trick. Yeah. Falcon, let me check the URL and find it for you. Give me a second. Because Muad'Dib created more than around 50 videos around Lightwave. And he goes deep on a lot of things. Okay. here. Let me paste it on the chat. Here are all the videos. And one of them, it has to do with the ScriptNet. I think it's the 42nd. And how you can create a render farm using Raspberry Pis. Check this out, it's very, very nice. And I will add the URLs at the description of the video as well, so that people can find it. Those who are going to watch the stream from the YouTube. They are using AmiBerry on Raspberry Pis, and then you can use Lightwave pretty easy. Yeah, he's very good, Liberal, you're right. So, this scene is called, as we said, ray trace, right? Okay. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to run this, the rendering of this screen, of this scene, and I will upload it on YouTube as well, so you can see the process, how I render it and how much time it will get. Okay, guys. So for today, that's all I would like to show you. Thank you very much for being here and watching and the stream, my stream. I hope you liked it, the topic of today's stream. Let me see if there is anyone we can go to. Leveler says have a workshop via YouTube. Workshop about that? What, Leveler? About the Lightwave? If you expect me to do a workshop about Lightwave, you are not going to learn a lot from that, because I'm not that good. I have an idea of something that I would like to build, but yeah, I'm not that good with Lightwave. Hammond Modify does a very good job, okay, with Lightwave. Muad'Dib is expert on Lightwave, he's the guru, and yeah, not me. I wish I were. Muad'Dib was doing the streams on Twitch last year. All these videos are streams that he was doing on Twitch. And I hope that he is going to return again soon, and he is going to continue with new topics on Lightwave or something else. In those videos, he's not using only Lightwave, but you are going to see how you can create a whole movie by synchronizing music and create other graphics using other programs as well. So give him some time and watch those videos, because they are very good. So before we close, I would like to thank you all, guys, for being here on this stream. One more Friday stream for AmigaOS. I would like also to thank my supporters. They support me from the Ko-fi website, which you can find it at ko-fi/Walkero. If you want to support me for what I'm doing, the streams, the applications that I'm creating, the open source applications that I'm creating for AmigaOS 3 and AmigaOS 4, I would like to remind you that 50% from my from the donations that I receive from all of my supporters every month are going to other Amiga projects, where I donate to one or two other Amiga projects to the developers of those projects, so to support interesting ideas and applications out there, or services. The other time we supported the website, the OS for the pod, and the hosting for this website. So we try to help as much people as possible. So by supporting me, remember, you support other projects, Amiga projects as well. Also, I would like to thank a lot the Amiga Pulse supporters, which is Daniel Zedlika, T. Liebelord, and Roman Kargin, who support me every month. Falcon 11 says, I have one question on your Python scripts. On my Morphos doesn't work. I have Python 2.5. Yeah, Falcon 11, they do not work because there is not a good support for SSL website for Python on Morphos. That's the reason. Otherwise, if the Python on Morphos had the support, these scripts would work just fine. I think a workaround that I have in my mind to bypass it, but it will need to rewrite all these scripts in a way that they are going to use another server without HTTPS requirement, and then get that information from there. But it will take some time, to be honest. But you don't need my scripts. You have a Wayfarer, right? So you can use that to play the videos. Thanks everyone for being here. Let me check if there is anyone we could raid. It sounds better. So yeah, I see Mel plays some retro games. Let's raid here. Have a good Friday evening, an awesome weekend, and see you next week. Thank you very much. Bye bye.